We thank you, Lord, that we have this opportunity to come and worship together and to worship you. Help us to worship in spirit and joyfully as we realize that without you, we are nothing. Lord, we pray for you to answer all the requests that's in this box. But we know that you know each and every need. You know each prayer request that's been put in that box. Lord, we know that you've answered several already. And we pray that you'll continue to that. And as often as we pray, we'll pray for that end. Lord, now we ask that you bless each one that's here, that you uplift our spirits this morning, that we might glorify you in all that we say and do. Lord, now just forgive us. We realize that we fail many times to do your will. And Lord, we just ask that you keep pushing us forward, that this church would grow as you would have it to grow, that it might be the beacon of light here in this community, that others might see and realize Christ lives within our hearts and within the hearts of this church. Lord, we ask your blessings upon your message this morning. May it touch our lives in such a way that our lives will become that glowing light for many who are lost without Christ will see. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. 13 people here. Is that an unlucky number?
Nope.
Nope? Okay, well, we're going to count 13 people and hold your Bible up and we'll get a count. We'll see if we have 13 Bibles here this morning. Bibles, if you will, one verse this morning. One verse. But that's the scripture, whether it's one verse or 150. You know, we could read the 119th Psalm. We might be here for another couple of days. We're going to be looking at Ephesians, the second chapter. Ephesians, the second chapter. You see my little red tag says scripture, all right? Somebody wrote scripture, just the word scripture. So again, that's what we're getting this morning, is a scripture. One scripture. Verse number 12 of the second chapter of Ephesians. I'm going to read it. And then we're going to take a look at what it says. That at that time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise. Here's the important part of that verse. Having no hope and without God in the world, having no hope and without God. The message this morning is without Him. That sounds like a song, doesn't it? Without Him. Someone been maybe, what, a couple of years, 3 years, four, I don't remember exactly, but I passed out little slips of paper. And I said, I want you to write down three of the songs that you like. Now stay with me. Write down three of the songs that you like. One, two, and three. Number one being the most favorite hymn that you like to sing. And I got all kinds of responses. And there was one response that was the number one song for this person. And that song was Without You. Do you know, anybody know who that might have been? Karen says, Doris Greer. And this morning, that's the message. Without Him. Without God in this world, you are without hope. You are without hope. Now I realize that there's probably some here that didn't get a chance to write down their song for me. But I have everybody that's here, I think, mostly everybody that's here, their number one song. And so I wanted to take a look at that song that Doris chose as her number one, Without Him. And I think probably Karen, you did the writing on this. She's got a couple other ones here. I want to take a look at that song. Now, somebody look in the new red book that you have there and find out what number that hymn is. Because I want you to kind of follow along with the words of that hymn as we go through this message this morning. And I'm sure it's in that big red book. But I don't know the number. I have a number here.
470.
So turn in your big red book, songbook, to 470. Is that what you said? 470. Okay. And while you're looking at that hymn, you'll be following along with the scripture. 470 in the red book. And I'm going to write that up here because who knows? 470 red book. Is that anybody else's favorite hymn? I might have missed, or you didn't write it down. You know, it's hard to remember back. But I have a list of everybody's numbers. So if you haven't given me your three favorite hymns, your number one, two, and three, I'd appreciate you writing it on a slip of paper, even one of these little prayer slips. We got plenty of these, I'm sure. And give it to me, if you would. I don't think, Margaret, I have yours. Because that was probably done before you came back to Maranatha. All right, let's look at that hymn. Without Him, I could do nothing. The first verse, the first stanza. Without Him, I could do nothing. How many of you feel this morning, and I know the biggest percentage of the ones that are here are Christian, and you have Him. You're not without Christ in your life. So what I'm asking is, how many of you feel like that without Him, you could do nothing? But with Him, we can change the world, can't we? We can do great things. The Bible says, greater than these, we could do. Without Him, I'd surely fail. Does anybody here feel like a failure this morning? Feel like things just aren't going your way? You know, I have a tough time here lately of dropping almost everything I've tried to pick up. Or I'll make a move and I'll knock something over. It just seems like I can't get anything right anymore. surely fail. Without him, I would be drifting like a ship without a sail. You know how a ship on water has to have a sail unless it's one of powered boats. It has a 2-327 maybe stuck under the hood. But a ship at sea without a sail, without him I would be drifting. Do you know him? Are you drifting? Or are you with sail and you're sailing along with God in your life? Then we have to look at the second verse. It says, without him I would be dying. The Bible tells us that he is the only way. Jesus himself said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father. No man gets to heaven unless it goes through me. Without Jesus in your life, you're lost and you're dying. Without him, I'd be enslaved. Without Jesus in our lives, every day, we are a slave to Satan. You either have Christ in your life, or you don't. And if you don't have Christ in your life on a daily basis, old Satan's got a hold of you. He doesn't work on everybody the same either. He knows your weaknesses, just like God knows your strengths. Without him, life would be hopeless. We would not only be sailing on the seas alone without a sail, but we wouldn't have any hope of ever reaching land again or safety in Christ. The Lord is the way. The Lord takes care of those who love him and who are following him. But Jesus, thank God, through Jesus, thank God, I'm saved. That's the last stanza on that verse. But with Jesus, thank God, I'm saved. You know, can you see how maybe Doris really had that as her number one song? I can, too. You know, I can see her coming down the aisle every Sunday that I was here trying out. And she'd stop back there at the back pew because that's where we always sat. We're still sitting in that back pew. We may have to start moving forward, though, or turn up the hearing aids. But she would stop back there. She says, are you coming back next Sunday? She always, always wanted to give a hug. She always wanted to let us know that she appreciated us being here. I remember visiting her in the nursing home over here, and I took her a cup. She liked Coke. And so I took her a Coke. While we walked into the lunchroom where she was sitting that day, her face lit up. And she saw that Coke. Those are the kinds of memories come through Jesus Christ. Through knowing that God has saved you. And where else would you want to be but with the Lord? But with the Lord. Do you know him today? Do you know him today? Don't turn him away. I'm reading the course line now. Don't turn him away. Jesus, oh Jesus, without him, how lost I am. You're lost. to save you. So that verse that we read in Ephesians is how God spoke to the Ephesian Christians through Paul, the apostle. And he said that at that time, you were without Christ. Without God, you had no hope. You are lost and dying, drifting along in a world where Satan has a hold of you every chance he gets. The only way is to know the Lord. I'm going to put this scripture in here because I don't know who wrote this one out, but that's going to fill our box up some more. And the scripture was that one that we read. Are you without Him or are you with Him? If you're with the Lord, you're saved. If you're without Him, you have no hope. Let's pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we do thank you this morning for these few words. And Lord, we want you to know that as we look into our lives and we realize that without Him we are lost and hopeless in this world in which we live, not knowing exactly, Lord, what tomorrow or the next day might hold, but we know that if we have you in our life, we are saved, and heaven is our goal. Lord, your blessings upon each one that's here in this service this morning, and may your will above all be accomplished. Lord, it's in Jesus' name.